free healthcare, higher education, common knowledge available to all, food and housing paid by the government. You just have to do your part. Do the work for the common good, and all will be provided for you and everyone else. Does this sound like freedom? Living the dream? Not so much. Not if you truly understand how the economy works and really know governmental structure in its original intent according to the Constitution. If people are seen as simple wage earners, merely working to pay exorbitant taxes for the greater good and paying off unsustainable levels of debt, this creates a hamster wheel effect, in turn producing more poverty. Once this is achieved, we have class warfare, dividing people into the rich and the poor, causing discontent, making it easier to raise more taxes across the board. After all, the poor are easier to control and will not fight back if everything they need to live is provided for them with no incentive to do better for themselves, to practice self-development and personal accountability. Furthermore, remove the ability to defend themselves from thieves or other shady characters, and a police state is imminent. And when it comes to education, it's important to take control of what people read and listen to. Take control of what children learn in school. This has already been happening for decades. How many times have you heard of parents raising concern about the types of subjects taught in public school without parental consent? Things like sexual orientation, certain religious practices, or political activism. Then there's college. There are plenty of liberal colleges out there with instructors that not only profess, but preach their own ideology in the classroom, instead of sticking with an objective curriculum. And look at the media industry. Look who owns them. In the United States, only 6 large corporations own all the media corporations and affiliates nationwide. Researching who owns large shares of stock investments in those corporations is quite the eye-opener when you think about how much of the mainstream media is slanted to tell only half-truths and sometimes outright lies. But that's yet another speech for another day. Does any of this sound familiar yet? It should, because these principles are what the current system is being influenced by. However, they are not what most constitutional governments were actually built upon. What's actually happening now is a glimpse of what certain ideologists hope to create in the elusive utopian socialist state. Why? Because many politicians and government officials have followed the principles taught by Saul Alinsky and continue to apply them to the way they govern today. Alinsky was an American community activist and political theorist. He is largely responsible for his work through the Chicago-based Industrial Areas Foundation that incited poorer communities to protest and sometimes riot against landlords, politicians, and business leaders. At first glance, the theory of collectivism may sound like an ideal concept, but it is ideal only when applied to actually benefit society as a whole, not just a few elite. When it only benefits the elite, that's when the true concept of collectivism has unfortunately morphed into socialism. Throughout history, nations based on socialism eventually succumb to communism because their system is already hardwired to be vulnerable to tyranny and authoritarianism. When you look beyond the surface and dig deep into the issues, the scales fall off and you begin to have insight into what is really happening. Think about the current governmental system of each of these countries today, many of which were socialist prior to falling victim to authoritarianism or outright communism. People's Republic of China, Cuba, North Korea, and Venezuela. In today's new normal, freedom of speech and individual and property rights are being infringed upon by political systems worldwide that are becoming increasingly authoritarian. It's like a strip of freedoms and drip drip of socialism purported by many ideologists today. Broadcast and social media are great tools for manipulation, propaganda, deception, and psychological operations, all being used to justify political actions and policies that destroy life, liberty, and justice for all. And therein lies one of the reasons freedom is retreating so rapidly. For none are more hopelessly enslaved than those who falsely believe they are free. those who believe themselves to be free disregard the fact that to be governed in the modern world is to be watched, inspected, and spied upon. This is probably because the devices for enslavement have never been so cynically chosen or so effective, but also because the real defenders, through fatigue, through despair, or through a false idea of strategy and efficiency, have turned away. It is often said that one cannot solve a problem if one is not even cognizant of it. The notion that capitalism is a great sin is promoted by many politicians. Therefore, socialism is indoctrinated into youth at school via popular culture, championed by select talking heads in the entertainment and media industries. If these half-truths about are not exposed, they could prove to be the subtle kisses of death for freedom in our generation. The doctrine of socialism has been put into practice by many dictators, such as Hitler, Lenin, and Stalin, purporting death, destruction, and suffering on a megascale as the end result. In each socialist communist country, placing the good of society above the good of the individual towards such unfortunate outcomes is not a display of compassion. To sacrifice our personal interests for the greater good of our society at first glance seems entirely altruistic. But it is indeed communism, cloaked in such a trendy term as socialism. When people are coerced into doing unreasonable things, they will either resent it or outright rebel. So when it comes to stripping freedoms, calling for trivial authoritarian rule, there will always be somebody watching over to make sure those rules are followed. It could be your colleague, your neighbor, or worse yet, a friend. People without loyalty toward each other are easier to command, and thus, easier to control. It is this collectivist morality that has served as justification for every dictatorship and every atrocity, past or present. It's an inquisition. That's what they're calling for. So the next time you think of socialism, or even support it, at least do some research on its impact. Otherwise, be careful what you wish for. In many of the countries presented, socialism did bring equality to all. It brought equal misery and suffering. Just ask any Cuban, Chinese, North Korean, or Venezuelan why they immigrated out of their mother country. That is when you'll hear a very different story from what you may be hearing from school or from the news. You just might hear the truth.